Today we're reviewing the Suron X, an electric dirt bike with a top speed of 48 miles per hour, an advertised range of 40 miles, full suspension, and 19-inch dirt wheels. In a previous video, we reviewed the Segway X160, the smaller and less powerful version of the Suron. We'll be taking a look at the latest 2020 version to figure out if this is the best electric dirt bike you can buy. The Suron can be bought from lunacycles.com, and they are the exclusive seller for it in North America. We bought our Suron locally fully assembled, but when you buy it new, there is some assembly required. The Suron is the closest affordable replacement to a gas dirt bike around. We actually think that this can be better than owning a traditional dirt bike for some people. The Suron is lightweight at 100 pounds, zero emissions, and nearly silent. The power-to-weight ratio is amazing, allowing you to easily maneuver the bike and hit features you normally wouldn't feel confident riding. The bike doesn't get hot, and there's little to no maintenance with the electric motor. It's also much easier to load into a car or truck, and you can lay it flat since there's no gas or oil to worry about. Looking at the specs, the Suron has an exposed aluminum frame with no body panels. It has a 40-inch height with 10.6 inches of ground clearance. The battery is a gigantic 60-volt 32-amp pack, which puts out a peak of 7,000 watts of power. The battery is housed in the middle of the bike, under a locked compartment at a weight of 20 pounds, and can be quickly swapped out. The motor is direct drive with a chain and large sprocket, which helps create 18 foot-pounds of torque with a single-speed powertrain. The exact numbers of horsepower and torque do vary based on how you calculate them, but it performs similar to a 125cc gas bike. We love the acceleration and speed of this bike, and we're pretty blown away with how well it handles in the dirt and sand. We were equally impressed with how fast it slowed down, thanks to its front and rear four-piston hydraulic disc brakes. It also has regenerative braking, which will slow you down using the motors while putting power back into the battery. While the Suron doesn't have an app or Bluetooth connectivity, it does come with an included dongle that hooks up between the bike harness and the battery in order to program the regen levels. Using the handlebar as a toggle switch, you can change between three settings of regen, or you can turn it off completely. For lights, the Suron has a dual LED front headlight which is very bright, along with a rear tail light. However, the tail light stays illuminated and does not light up when you brake. There is also no toggle switch for the lights, so they are always on and you can't turn them off. On the left side of the handlebar is the digital display, which will display your speed in the middle, and the trip odometer in the bottom right, which you can reset with a small button. There's a toggle switch between Sport and EP mode, which turns down the throttle and top speed in case you want to save battery. Looking at the suspension, it features a DMN Volcano dual crown fork and a rear coil with 8 inches of travel. You can also adjust the preload and rebound, and the stock suspension is surprisingly good and handled everything we put it through. You also have the option of upgrading the suspension of the Suron, since it's the same as mountain bikes. Riding the Suron off-road is a blast, especially how it compared to the Segway X160 we reviewed in a previous video. We also rode with a CRF 250L. Obviously, the Suron got dusted on the straightaway, but it held its own on the trails and was way more agile. But in a drag race, the initial torque from the electric motor is impressive. Just watch how it even gets the jump off the line next to the KLR 650 and the Segway X160. Looking at the range, Suron advertises a range of up to 40 miles, but it's dependent on how you ride, the weight, and the type of terrain you ride on. Typically, a dirt bike range is measured in the number of hours they can be ridden off-road. We put it to the test, riding on a long dirt path in sport mode going between 30 to 45 miles per hour the entire time. We also stopped into a sand pit to do some riding for 15 minutes. By the end of the ride, we had done 23 miles and 2 hours of riding, and the battery was down to 10%, which causes it to go into eco mode. If you're looking to get the advertised 40 miles of range, you would have to ride it a lot slower and less aggressive. For upgrades, the bike is easy to customize and there are plenty of options. When it ships from Lunacycles, it's the matte gray frame that comes with green stickers that you can apply. We also recommend right away upgrading to the Shimano Saint brake pads. Our stock pads were squeaking, and we noticed an improvement in brake fade and stopping power with the Shimano. We also upgraded to 3-inch aluminum Pro Taper handlebars, which really improved handling and comfortability on the trails. The Suron features a cable throttle, which does the trick, but we noticed it starting to stick. So we upgraded ours to a quarter-turn electric throttle from Magura. We also replaced our tires to Dunlop Geomax MX33 tires. There's plenty of other mods out there for the Surron, including larger battery upgrades, Supermoto street wheels, or swapping out the chain with a belt. We'll leave links in the description of the video to all the different upgrades we showed and others. All right, that's it for now. Next up, be sure to watch our review of the Segway X160 and the comparison against the Surron and the Super 73.